Hey, I'm Leslie. How do you do?
Puppeteer.
Okay, what
do you like being a puppeteer?
What's it like being a puppeteer? Well, if you could imagine, do you like to draw and create characters? It's really magical because I feel like I can bring something to life. And I do a lot of artwork and drawing, and so Abby started out as a drawing and an idea, and then when she became a puppet, then I got to bring my heart and my ideas and everything to life. So it's kind of like being an animator. Like, animators get to draw characters and then have somebody voice them and everything. When you're a puppeteer, you get to bring the character to life without waiting for it to be animated or cartoon or drawn. The minute you put it on, you have a character that can hug people and interact with people. Like, you know, you watch cartoons, right? Or you watch, did you see Frozen, I'm wondering? See those characters like Elsa and the snowman? Those are drawn, but I would have to wait to voice something. When you're a puppeteer, you bring a character to life immediately. And you can bring it into the real world at any time. So that's what it's like. It's like being a real superhero.
Start. How does someone start? How do you start?
How do you start being a puppeteer?
Everybody starts differently, but because I started as an artist and I used to make a lot of things, I just started by making puppets. I would, by putting a sock on my hand. Look, I'm a puppeteer right now. Hold your hand up. Hello. Hello? You're a puppeteer, and you just started. So I think you start by finding something that you love to do, and you just practice, and you just start by making your own puppet. I am a writer as well, and so I wrote a show, and someone from the Henson Company came and saw a show that I did 18 years ago and said, you have a lot of voices and characters, would you like to audition for the Muppets? And I did. And there was hundreds and hundreds of people, and I just happened to be the lucky one that got down to 50, then 20, then 10, and then it was just me. And then I thought, this is something I really love to do, so I kept doing it.
That's me. What's it like working?
What's it like working on Sesame Street?
It's the best job in the whole wide world. I get to get up early in the morning, I walk on set, and there's Hooper's store, and there's the steps of 1, 2, 3, and there's all my friends at work, all the people behind the cameras, all the writers, all the producers, and then all the other Muppeteers, and we get together, and we look at a script, and we thought, this is the story we're gonna tell today. And then we all get together and we're like, who's gonna tell the story? How about Cookie Monster and Rosita and Zoey and Abby? And then we all get our characters together and we tell a story every day. And we get to tell it to the people on set, the people that come and visit, and then the people that watch us on TV. So it's like being really having a fun job telling stories every day. Is that it? Are we good?
Yeah, she had a couple more. Did you want favorite, except for Abby?
Except for Abby, who's your favorite puppet on Sesame Street?
I'm glad you asked that because I have a new favorite character that I like. Well, I have this one little monster that shows up that I'm always trying to get on the show. And her name's Eleanor. It's this little pink monster. But I recently have this penguin named Penelope, and she's really overexcitable and everything, and she's super funny, and she laughs like this. She's the funniest, little quirkiest little penguin, and she's kind of got too much energy, which is like me, and she has to learn to calm down, but she loves life, and that's my new favorite, Penelope Penguin. She was just in an episode with Big Bird, and she's also in an episode with Elmo called Airplane the Musical, where she's getting married.
My daddy. My daddy.
My daddy watched Sesame Street when he was a little kid, and I'm watching it now.
Yeah.
What's it feel like to be working for that?
I feel like Sesame Street is like the Olympics of children's television. You know, when you train for something and there's all these different events and everything, and then you have this one really magical event called Sesame Street, and then you're part of something that you know has helped kids and adults grow together and be kind. And I think Sesame Street's in how many countries? 150?
Yeah, actually more than 150.
Yeah, we're in countries all over the world. So I feel like I'm part of a superhero team, super friends. So I love it. I also grew up with Sesame Street. When I was your age, I told my mom and dad that I wanted to move to Sesame Street. I packed my bags and everything. My sister remembers me. I'm like, I'm going to Sesame Street. I want to live there. So I kind of got my dream.
And five.
But do you want to be when you were five?
Oh, a dog. I love dogs a lot. I think I've always loved dogs, so probably just, I've known my whole life that I wanted to make people smile, and I love to sing, probably as much as I love to draw, so I really wanted to sing, and I do a lot. I sing in my own shows all the time, sometimes in my own voice and sometimes not.
What do you think?
Thank you.
Thank you for saying thank you. Can I get a fairy hug? Wait, arms on back. There you go. Thanks for the interview.